Welcome to TMS WEB Core with Firestore. Firestore will allow you to connect to a database within minutes. But before we start looking at the actual implementation, let me give you a brief introduction to databases and web development. Most likely, the first thing as a Delphi developer you struggle with when doing web development is that databases aren't as easy to incorporate into your applications as, for example, with a VCL application. Even with a mobile application, it's much easier. The reason is simple. TMS Web Core applications are downloaded into the browser and executed inside of the web browser at the end customer's computer. But the web browser, of course, is limited of what a web browser can access. For example, a web browser cannot access local resources and definitely can't connect to a database server that might be located inside of your local area network. For this, the solution is web services. Web services provide HTTP, or better even HTTPS, encrypted endpoints that can be accessed over the internet, and those web services access your database. That means the web browser never ever establishes a direct connection to your database. The web application cannot access your database directly. That is done by the web service with prepared endpoints that you as the developer prepare with a so-called API. This API specifies how the web application can communicate with the database. Just as a side note, there can be web services, of course, without databases, but in this particular case, we're going to look at this use case having a web service that gives you access to a database. The issue at hand is that these web services take time to implement. We've got great tools in the Delphi world, for example, TMS Xdata, a great tool which even allows you to reverse engineer your existing databases and publish them as a web service. A great tool to get the job done, but sometimes you want it even easier without having to provide the infrastructure for these web services. You might just want to develop a web application and look at an existing solution on the internet that provides you this database functionality. Google Firebase is one of those solutions. Instead of connecting to your own infrastructure, you connect to your Firebase inside of the internet with your web application, and Firebase provides the database services. One thing up front, Firebase and Firestore are two different things. Firebase is the development platform from Google that offers lots of services, and Firestore are the database services inside of that platform. And TMS Web Core, with its recent release, makes it easy to use a Firestore database in your web application. So instead of implementing a web service yourself, you use the Firebase platform with its Firestore database functionality to provide database storage inside of your web applications. What makes TMS Web Core special is that you can build on existing knowledge connecting to Firebase services. TMS introduces wizards and other functionality into the IDE that lets you connect to Firebase Firestore databases within minutes. So without further ado, let me give you a brief introduction. The example that we're going to build now is something that you have most certainly built a dozen times in a VCL application or FireMonkey application. You want to build a form that allows you to access a database showing a grid of the records inside of the database. And the easiest way to do that, of course, in Delphi is to use a grid. And that's exactly what we're going to use in TMS Web Core as well. So we start by saying File, New, when we go to Other and select TMS Web, TMS Web Application. Now TMS Web Core, of course, is going to build all the parts of the project that we need. We end up with the main form. And the next step is to store the application. And now we can pick exactly the parts that we would normally pick in a VCL application from the tool palette. So we pick a grid. And in addition to the VCL components or FireMonkey components, I also have the WebDB grid. I can just just drop on the form, drag it like this. And then there's also the data source. Now, the difference is it's called TWeb data source right here. So this will then link to a data set. And guess what? TMS provides a Firestore client data set for us. And this is the key component that is the focus of this video. This component not only contains the capability to connect to a Firestore database and gives us the ability to connect a data source and then use visual UI controls to interact with this data set. Now, in addition to that, TMS also built a binding editor that allows us to very, very comfortably do everything from inside of the IDE. If you've ever worked with a Firestore database before, usually you need to go online onto the internet, use the browser interface from Google to set up your tables, which are called collections in Firestore, and then add all the different fields to the database. And all that can be done from the Delphi IDE, just like this. There's no additional work required. So after dropping the data set on the form, I rename it to data set to make it easier to access. And the first step is to define the API key, the auth domain, and the project ID. These three things are described in the documentation, how you acquire those. And I'm going to skip this. We might cover this in a later video. You will get this after setting up your account with Google. Then you will retrieve these three things. These have to be kept secret. And for that particular reason, I'm moving everything here to the right so that you can see the actual values that I'm going to copy paste into my project. I've added all the information to my data set. And now, if you have already created your database, you're ready to go. If you have your database and your table, you would now specify the collection name, which is the table name. You would specify the key field name, and you're ready to go. However, we don't have a table yet. The only thing we have, we created the database space online. We've received our API key, the domain, the project ID. However, we have not received or created a table yet. And that's exactly what we can do easily from inside of the IDE by using the Firestore binding editor. So, but there, if you click that, it tells you a collection name is required. So essentially, you have to specify the name of the collection that you plan to use inside of the data set. So in this case, I'm simply going to say, okay, I'm going to use the collection name people. Well, that's it. So I right click again, binding editor, and I see all the settings from a previous project. So if you do this the first time, you will have to specify the client ID, the secret, the URI, and the project ID again. Also, the token is something that was retrieved automatically by the binding editor. So if you do this for the first time, all these fields will be empty and you will have to fill out the first four with the information as described in the documentation. The nice thing is that TMS stores this for you. So you only have to do this once. And as soon as you connect successfully to your database, it will be there for you. So the only thing I have to do now is to click connect and I'm connected and I get people, because I specified people as a collection name right here, and I can start adding fields to this table. For example, I can say I want to add a name of type string. Other data types are Boolean, integer, float, date, time, and blob. So let's take another string. Let's add the birthday as a date time value. So if you like, select date time. Let's also add email of type string and wages as a floating point value, and also the number of children as an integer value. These are all just exemplary values. Just a heads up, so the list of fields is right here. We now have to synchronize it with the backend, meaning what is in the internet. This is right now just stored inside of the IDE. So you click here to synchronize this. And also, don't be afraid if you were to forget it. If you close the wizard, you would get a reminder, hey, you have to synchronize first. So we synchronize it. And now the remote table settings have been updated, and we're ready to transfer this definition into our data set. So we click the Delphi icon to use the fields inside of Delphi. And with that, you might think, oh, the fields are there. You go to the field editor, and voila, the fields are inside of your data set. And also the types, birthday, date, time, email is string, name is string, number of children is an integer field, wages is a float field. And the next step could be you could specify the display format and all the things that are used to from the VCF. Everything is supported as if it were a normal T data set with a T data source inside of the VCL. So the last step should be to make sure that the grid is connected to the data source and the data source is connected to the data set. Let's verify that. Click on the data source, we select the data set, and we click on the grid and we select the data source for the grid. And right away, we get the column description of the information presented in the data set. And I'm not going to customize this. I really want to give you the impression what you get without customizing anything. So the next step would be just to add a little bit more usability, to add a navigator to the form. Navigator, TWEB DB Navigator called. DB Navigator is the VCL control. WEB DB Navigator is the TMS Web Core control. And also for this one, we need to specify the data source, select WEB data source. Of course, you can rename this to data source to make it a little bit shorter. With all this, we only need to write one tiny little line of code. We want the data set to be open when our application is run. So we double click on the form, which gives us the form create event. And there we can insert dataset.open. As I've said so many times, just like for any VCL app that you've written so far. No difference for TMS Web Core. And at this point, run the application, store the application, run the application, and the magic happens. TMS Web Core is now preparing your web application and runs it inside of the browser. So the application is started inside of the browser, but we get an error message. We have not specified the key field name yet. With regard to the key field, this might be a little bit tricky at first, because I myself thought when I read the documentation, key field, that means it's the field in the index that is used to sort your entries inside of the collection or table. That is not the case. The key field is actually the field that is used to make a record unique. And by default, if you right click the data set again and go into the binding wizard and connect, always if you like, why are the tables empty? You have to connect again, you connect, and then in the tables, you see here, we now have ID as an additional field. And this is automatically added by the IDE integration from TMS or from Firestore, because every table has an ID field by default. If you don't create it, it will be created for you. So we are able to specify ID as our ID field. So let's sync with Delphi again, add all fields. There's no changes. So we should be able to specify ID as our field. We run. And the application presents an empty grid because we haven't added anything to the database yet, to the table yet. So now we click plus, we insert, and the grid presents us with the ability to enter a birthday. For example, we can say 1978-10-11. And we set the email to superuser@google.com. The name we set to superuser. The number of children we set to 5. And the wages we set to 250,000 1,000. And we post the record. Boom, done. Entering values in the grid according to the data type, all supported automatically. And if we now close and restart the application, the data is being retrieved from the Firestore database, and we can add more records, modify not so super user, for example, and the changes are being posted when we click on the checkmark here. So you have full database capability outside from the IDE. As soon as you define your Firestore database online with Google, you can use the RedStudio IDE inside of a TMS Web Core project to create all your collections, automatically transfer all the fields and the definitions into the dataset field editor, and then develop your applications, your web applications, precisely as you've done so for years inside of the VCL. All of this is possible with TWeb Firestore client dataset. This is what Delphi developers have been looking for years with TMS Web Core. You can focus on developing your web applications, on developing your table structure, your databases, and you no longer have to take care of the backend. The backend is provided for you, and best of all, you can configure the backend outside of the IDE, define tables with data types that you've been using for years, and use components like a data source and a grid that you've also been using for years and years. Stay tuned for more videos about advanced features, how you can filter records, sort records, and all that kind of stuff, because that is also possible, like with any other data set that you're used to working with inside of the VCL. TMS Web Core allows the same kind of features at the click of a button. Stay tuned.